Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing.
In Northern Ireland when the pulse was first put into place back in 1960. So Mona was described as a really influential and inspirational nurse leader. And people said of her that she was wise and was a nurse with extensive professional experience and a sense of humour and a deep love of nursing. So I hope she'd be very proud of what we're actually doing here this evening, setting out on this journey around transforming the perceptions of nursing is what we're about. My name is Paul Vaughan, and I'm the Director of Nursing for Transformation at NHS England. And alongside me this evening, he says, next slide. There we go. Alongside me this evening is Wendy Preston, who many of you will know here at RCN Congress, who's the head of practice at RCN and chair of the Association of Respiratory Nurse Specialists. And I have Helen Bevan alongside us, the Cheif Transformation Officer for NHS Horizons.
The RCN and NHS Horizons have been working really closely with us on this piece of work, and we would never be able to achieve what we have without their input. So it's fantastic that all of us working together are really making a difference about what we're trying to achieve. Those of you who came to the stand that was in the exhibition hall over the last 2 days when we were doing the piece of work that we're doing, if you've spoken to us, you will have heard that in this piece of work, there are three kind of key themes to the work. One about working with young people, teachers, parents to change the perceptions of nursing, to see it as a career of choice and what a fantastic place it is to come and work, to be a nurse or a midwife. The middle strand of work is about working with nurses themselves. A lot of nurses tell us, if you ask them, and I suppose I could look for a show of nods in the audience, when you ask them, would you recommend nursing to your family and friends or any of your children, so many nurses nowadays will say that they would not recommend nursing to a family member to become a nurse. And that's really not helpful in terms of the situation that we're in, and we have to ask ourselves why, and how do we re-engage and re-inspire nurses to really get them to be saying what a fantastic profession, and how do we sell that to others? Because if we don't do that, we'll never get the future generations of nursing coming on stream. And the third piece of work that we have is around looking at how do we influence key stakeholders, policymakers, the media, politicians, how do we influence them to change their view of nursing? And that so far is the one work stream that we hadn't done a lot of work around. And in all of the work we've been doing, just to set it in context for you, what we've not wanted to do is to say to people, this is what you need to do, this is what we're going to do. It's been about using social movement to engage people, nurses and midwives, to say, what do you think we need to do? And through that approach, working with NHS Horizons, Helen, Bev and the team, we've really managed to galvanize ideas from nurses and midwives that have built on what you're going to hear from Wendy, some of the fantastic building blocks that we've built all of this work upon. So it's really, really fantastic that we've managed to be able to do that. So the next slide is about just telling you what we've been doing in the past 2 days. As I said, this is the first ever virtual hackathon in the NHS. And what is a virtual hackathon, if you don't know? The slide there is explaining to you. It is about getting teams of people to come together to kind of think about a very practical project about how they can make a difference around that. And then they kind of test, create some breakthrough thinking about what can we do differently. The virtual hackathon, as you say, is virtual, so it means that we've been doing it in the ether of the internet. And the team from NHS Horizons have been amazing, offering virtual coaching, running Zoom sessions, bringing all of the teams that we've had involved, offering them support to develop their ideas over the period of time that we've been working on this hackathon. So what we've had, it says 57 teams there, actually we had 59 teams who were signed up to create a solution to one of three challenges. So they could choose which one of the issues they wanted to address. Was it about nurses and midwives and policy making? Was it around the perceptions of nursing through the media, how we're perceived as a profession? Or was it around how we can connect and network better within our professions? And what they were asked to do was, they had to make a 2-minute film. The end result of what they had to come up with was a short two-minute film that would present their ideas to a panel of judges. That was what we were going to do. And what we've done is we've ended up with 5 short films that we want to share with you around what the ideas that they came up with for this piece of work. So at the beginning here, what we're going to do, I'm going to take you through in a second those 5 films. And these are going to be the 5 films you're going to see in a minute. Just before we do those 5 films, what we're going to do, the prize that we do have a prize, and the winning team will get an invite through one of the Lords to go down to the Houses of Parliament and visit the Houses of Parliament. They'll spend time with Jane Cummings in a coaching session. So they'll get a really good opportunity to kind of think then, how do we take their idea forward? But the other thing that we want to do, as well as the judging panel making the decision about the winner, is just get a People's Choice Award. So you were all given, when you came in, a post-it note. So when you've seen all five films, we want you to write on your post-it note the film that you think is the idea that you'd like to see progressed. And depending on which team win that award, we also have a prize where they will go and spend time with the NHS Horizons team so they can think about how they can take their idea going forward. What we'd also ask you to do, if you haven't already signed up as a nurse ambassador, if you write on your post-it note your email address, we will follow you up with getting you to become a nurse ambassador. When you hear about the 30-day challenges, Wendy will tell you about those. You can sign up to be one of those nurse ambassadors. So if I go back to the films, the first film you're going to see is from Lincolnshire Partnership NHS Foundation Trust, and it's called 52 Faces. And it's a really creative idea around changing media perceptions around nursing. And what they're suggesting doing is, over the course of a year, is taking a member of staff, linking that member of staff to somebody who receives care, and producing either a blog or a little film around that experience to really evidence the difference that nursing makes to people's lives. This trust is a mental health and learning disabilities nursing trust. It's a fantastic wee film, and I'm now going to ask for it to be played.
Hi, we are Team Expectation versus Reality, the team representing Lincolnshire Partnerships Foundation NHS.
Hold on one sec, technology. We'll just get you the visuals now.
Hi, we are Team Expectation versus Reality, the team representing Lincolnshire Partnerships Foundation NHS Trust. We are the mental health and learning disabilities provider for Lincolnshire. Our campaign, in a nutshell, is what do you think I do versus what I...
So we're just going to, we have a slight technical problem. We're just going to fix that technical problem. I suppose I could just ask Helen in the meantime, in terms of the work overall and what we've been doing, do you want to just give us a view from your point of view about what's been happening and how you've been finding it?
Yeah, so the work around transforming perceptions of nursing and midwifery has been going on for over a year. So Jane Cummings, the Chief Nursing Officer for England, announced this at her summit in March 2017. And ever since then, we've been working with hundreds of nurses and midwives to think about how can we transform and improve perceptions of nursing and midwifery as the brilliant careers that they are. So we started with some meetings to get the focus of the topics, and then we ran a crowdsourcing platform where we got about 20,000 interactions where people put their ideas forward. Then we've had some face-to-face hackathons where people come together for a day. We've got the virtual hackathons that's been happening the last 2 days, and Wendy's going to tell us about what's going to happen next. So, a lot's been happening and an awful lot of people have been engaged, and I think there's a lot of energy around this topic. How are we doing? Yay.
Hi, we are Team Expectation versus Reality, the team representing Lincolnshire Partnerships Foundation NHS Trust. We are the mental health and learning disabilities provider for Lincolnshire. Our campaign, in a nutshell, is what do you think I do versus what I actually do. So, for each of the 52 weeks of the coming year, members of our nursing team, selected from a wide variety of our services, will talk about the reality of what they do on a day-to-day basis compared with the perceived images of mental health and learning disabilities nursing. Okay. They will also give an insight into who they are and why they came into nursing. This will be published on our website as a vlog. For each of those accounts, there will also be a corresponding service user story telling us how nurses have impacted on their recovery and how nurses have helped them in their journey.
Part of my role is to rehabilitate patients so that they can live as independently in the community as possible. Part of that is we've developed a service user-led cafe, and therefore the patients can come down, they can work, they can learn new skills, socialise with people, and then have references and qualifications to go back into the community to make themselves more independent in their life.
I started off with no confidence whatsoever, and working on the CAF has given me that confidence back. I didn't have any people skills, and I've learnt now using the phone, talking to anybody who comes in the CAF as a customer, and working as a team with the other patients that were in the CAF. I've got two qualifications out of it, both a level 2 and a level 3 in food and hygiene, and I also managed to get a peer support job in the CAF, which then led me to be able to work on a ward.
We already have a great relationship with our local media, so we'll be using them and our relationships with them to target this out towards the local population, using social media, looking at taking the message out into schools and any other areas where people might be thinking about recruiting into nursing. Our campaign has extensibility in the fact that it can be scaled up or down, it can be used by other organisations, and we're hoping that it will form the basis of a recruitment campaign, not just for nursing staff, but for assistant practitioners and for anybody else who wants to work in mental health services.
So that's the first film, and that team were asked by the judges, one of the questions they were asked is, if they're going to do this every week, 52 weeks of the year, that's a lot of people, how do you get those stories? And they already were able to demonstrate that they had 50 people lined up to tell their story. So that was that first piece of work.
I think we should like applaud it.
Absolutely. Yeah. The next piece of work is from Dorset Healthcare, and they call theirs Nannia Days. And they involved over 100 nurses in their piece of work in coming up with creating their idea and testing it out. And they've got this great idea about building on the idea of twin towns. You know, when you have twinnings with towns. So we're kind of taking that concept and thinking in terms of how do you then twin people in different jobs so they get a really good insight into what other people do so that you get the networking, sharing best practice. You could do this on a local level, you could do it on a regional level, you could do it on a national level. And they thought through how much time would be needed to do this and how you could really scale it up on a much bigger scale. They've thought all of that through. So we're now going to move to the second film, which is Nannia Days.
We are Dorset Healthcare, hashtag celebrate nursing. We have been working locally with over 100 nurses in our local hackathon. We took our idea from our hackathon, voted on our democracy, and we brought it together today to what we've now described as Nannia Days. So Nannia Days are where you go and you share, connect and learn from other nurses, either locally and or nationally. So we really share across the whole nursing community different styles of nursing, ways we nurse, learning and opportunities. So watch the rest of our video.
In the room we have 2,096 years and 8 months of nursing experience.
Works as our clinical assurance lead for our trust bank, but today she walks through Nannia and she emerges as Natalie, who's working on Ward B.
We believe that the best way for nurses to connect and learn is through shared experience.
Nannia Days!
Great. So you can hear their energy and enthusiasm around that idea, going into the wardrobe and coming out as somebody different. How exciting would that be? And when they were being questioned, one of the things that they've got support from the senior team, both the chief executive and the nursing team within that trust. So again, a really great idea. The next team are the NHS Sustainable Improvement Team. They wanted to tackle the policy issues, that how do we influence around policy? And the kind of three things that they felt that they would like to explore and really tackle is that nurses are a really big group. So how powerful they think that they could be if they were really influencing around policy. They think that nurses really need to believe the fact that they can actually shape policy, and we need to somehow develop that collective voice. So in their presentation, and their, what they were trying to make happen is just that. And I love the idea that they come up with around policy shakers is what they talk about. So I'm not quite sure what the policy shaker would do every time they meet. But anyway, have a look, and here's this film. So again, when the judges were pushing them on some of their ideas about how they'd make that happen, they were saying that there's what they recognize is there's lots of existing programs out there where we could be embedding some of this work into it. So again, a really good project there. Great idea. And I think I said at the beginning, I just want to reiterate, all of the films that we had, even those we're not showing, all of those ideas will be taken and contribute to the work stream. The next one was one that was kind of done here at Congress and was done by a small team of people who were here. And I think it's a really, it just shows how quickly you can pull some really good ideas together and get them out there and on paper. So the Flow Scholars here are here in Belfast, and this was their video.
Hi everybody, we are the Flow Scholars. And the subject that we're going to talk about today is how do we get the media to promote nursing and midwifery as a desirable profession.
On International Nurses Day, we were pretty horrified to find that Trish Greenholm had tried to tweet and use social media icons around nursing. And when she looked at the emoji available to represent nursing, they were pretty scary. Nurses, the sexy syringe look. So our idea is to look at how we redesign the image of nursing on social media, particularly in emojis, and we'd like to propose a hackathon to take that forward.
Yeah, I think we need to get together lots of people, designers, and people who are savvy on social media and start to look at how we can be portrayed differently through the use of emojis. If you choose an emoji on Apple and it's a running person, for example, actually it actually allows you to choose different characteristics, so different colour hair, different skin colour and so on. We need to promote nursing in that type of way using emojis, and a hackathon would perhaps enable us to do that.
We could bring in the expertise of our millennial colleagues. We need artists, graphic designers, we need the software houses, we need children, we need the corporates, we need fine artists, those who can think differently about the way in which we can symbolise the great things about nursing.
And then finally, we need to utilise our universities, our undergraduates across the whole health and care professions to work together with their media undergraduate students. It'd be a fantastic project for somebody to do cross-departmental. They do it for other reasons, why not do it for this?
If we expect people to be digital professionals, we need to give them the right tools for the job, and this would be one of the tools that we could provide for people.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Great. So that's a really simple idea that could make a real difference to how people perceive nursing. And I know when I set out on this work, to do this work originally, when I Googled some images around nursing, the kind of things you see are not always good on the internet. So this is one of those ideas where you could really begin to make a difference with that. The last project you're going to see is Care Together, Share Together. And it was a group of people who came together from completely different areas across England, and they worked virtually, and they were from both health and social care. So that's what's quite unique about this piece, which I think is really good. So they were really thinking about how about the people who working in the independent sector, in private care homes, in residential homes, how do you really build on making sure that they get recognised in terms of the work that they do, and they want to build on work that's already been done to really shape up how the difference they can make around networking to share experience. So we'll watch the video now.
We are a group of health and social care professionals with a passion for promoting and improving the way nurses connect, communicate, share, and learn from each other.
Our team is called Care Together, Share Together, because that is exactly what we need and want to do. There is no existing mechanism to bring all the health and social care organisations together, and we are going to change that. We are going to co-design and co-deliver a campaign to showcase how health and social care sectors are working together to deliver the best possible care by connecting, communicating, sharing and learning from one another. We will do this by bringing colleagues together using different communication platforms, including blogs, tweets, newsletters. The content will come from across all sectors to create a movement that will ensure the health and social care sector has visibility and is heard. The campaign will be underpinned by Jane Cummings' 30-day challenge, and each month the movement will have a different focus. For example, with care homes opening up and inviting colleagues from across all health and social care sectors to come and join them for coffee and a chat, to step into each other's worlds. The end result will celebrate the effective joint working relationships, demonstrating how we care together,
share together,
learn together,
grow together,
nurse together.
And when the judges were questioning that team, one of the things that struck me as, to be honest, I think it's a bit sad really, they were talking about one of the examples of a nursing home where they received outstanding in their CQC rating. And they said, you know, that was fantastic because it is about the people they care for creating the right environment. But actually, nobody really celebrated that with them. And in a way, what this would do, their idea would be, that could be celebrated and they could share that really good practice. So again, a really fantastic piece of work. So they were the five films. That's what's been going on over the last 2 days here at Congress. What's going to happen, if you wouldn't mind just taking 2 seconds now to do your vote. You've seen the five films. Do your vote. We'll quickly click them in. And then at the end, Helen's going to announce the winner when we get to the end. And we'll also announce, so it'll give us time to count the votes for the People's Award. In the meantime, what I'm going to do, I'm going to invite Wendy just to tell you a bit more about the work and the role that the RCN has been playing in the work. So, yeah. Wendy,
and
if you...
Can I just say, just while Wendy's coming up,
please
so
do.
We just want you to put the number, okay, on your post-it note. And if anybody's missing a pen or wants any help or wants a new post-it note, then Kate and Rosie there will help you. So they'll seamlessly collect these up and count them while Wendy's speaking. Sorry, can you put them back up, yeah? Yeah. Okay, we'll leave them up for one more minute, okay?
Just while you're doing that, I just want to say how fantastic it is to see such great work, and that's been done in less than a few hours, or even a few minutes in some cases. So it just shows you what you can do with a mobile phone. It's absolutely fantastic.
I mean, none of those people have ever made films before. It's incredible. So.
And a lot of them were also not meeting each other. They were virtually working together, so they weren't actually in the same room either. Okay.
I think we're ready, yeah.
So I'll keep this quite short, but I think it's the Royal College of Nursing is a partner in this programme. And it's great that we can work together to transform the perception of nursing and midwifery. And our members and staff have been involved all the way through the development, this social movement that I've developed, the campaign that I'm going to talk about later. And what we want you to do is to sign up as ambassadors and to all get involved. So as this campaign, as we've worked together through this social movement and developed through the various different hackathons, including the one that we've had here at Congress, I just wanted to share some of the slides and some of the resources that we've developed. So this first one, which I'm not going to go through in great detail, is the enemies. And actually, much that's been discussed at this Congress, but previous Congresses, you'll see there, everything has been picked up and the enemies, and that's helped us to develop the building blocks, which we'll talk about now. So these 10 building blocks, they started much further. They started with hundreds and hundreds of different ideas that have been brought together in themes to get to these final 10 building blocks. RCN members and staff have been involved as part of that process. So what I want to do is just sort of reflect on some of the either existing RCN work, but also future work, and how we work together to link some of the work that we're doing into addressing some of these building blocks. So, for example, a lot of you will have taken the work that we're doing around safer staffing, the publication that we've launched here at Congress, and that's part of a big programme around safer staffing. And as you see, that fits very well into lots of these different areas. And I'm trying to think of the one. But it all fits in very closely together. The career, we've got a career pathway programme which fits wonderfully in with building block number 3. Who got involved with hashtag this nurse? Who did a video? Who got involved? So showing pride in your profession fits very well there. Leadership programmes, we have lots and lots of different types of leadership programmes in the RCN, and I'm sure a lot of you will have been on some of those programmes. That fits lovely in with building block number 6. And celebrating nursing and practice, that's been a fantastic programme of sharing good practice that was launched to celebrate 100 years of the Royal College of Nursing, and that fits absolutely key into building block number 10, which is about investing in innovation. So they're just a few, and there's lots, and I can give lots of examples for all of the building blocks, but you know, there's lots and lots of work to do. So what we're going to be doing across the next year is having 30-day challenges, and this is a programme of across the next year of 30-day challenges, which we want you to get involved with as ambassadors. And as ambassadors, you'll then receive a pack with information about how to work together to galvanise that energy across the next year. I'm not going to go to them all in detail, but as you can see, there are lots of things that could really simply start to, and some of them will be quite simple, like putting registered nurse on your Twitter handle, and others there'll be lots more to get involved. And the RCM will be leading particularly, I wanted to pull two out, so next April, as you know, a lot of you hopefully will have been involved with the Royal College of Nursing's work that we do with our parliamentary colleagues, of arranging for you to have time to discuss with MPs about those key issues that we have in nursing midwifery. A lot of the issues that you'll have heard across Congress. And we will be facilitating time to be able to discuss those with either your local councillors or MPs nationally, depending which country that that you work in. So also, when you come to May, so next in a year's time, when we're looking at our campaign around Nurses Day, we'll be leading on this element about sharing the story of nursing and midwifery, either within your organisation or individually. And I think it's fantastic that we can work together on this programme across the next year to really try and address some of those enemies and to work on some of those building blocks so that we, in a year's time, we can look and reflect on and see what a change we've made. Thank you. Great.
Okay, so hello, my name's Helen Bevan and I'm part of the Horizons team, which is a small team. We're actually part of NHS England that supports making positive changes happen. And I just wanted to say how much we love working with the RCM and the nursing team within NHS England, and you know, thousands of nurses and midwives that are getting involved in this work. And you know, just to kind of back up with what Wendy was saying, I think there's really great opportunities to come and be an ambassador for this work. So an ambassador is somebody who works at a local level, who is going to be the kind of link between you know, what's happening in my own organisation and the campaign and the movement as a whole. So you can see there at the bottom, there's a link. And it's bit.do/future-nursing. So really, you know, recommend and encourage you to come and be part of that. So now we have the kind of the grand finale of the Mona Gray lecture, which is, and the winner is. So I'm going to announce two winners. The first winner I'm going to announce is the People's Choice. And then I'm going to announce the formal winner. So the People's Choice Award has come from you now. And the formal winner, we've had a panel of four judges. So all of our five finalists have done a session with interrogation with the judges. And I'll tell you the outcome of that. So let's go back to the actual shortlisted films. So you can see that. So first of all, I would like to announce that the winner of the People's Choice Award is number 4, Flow Scholars, okay, with emojis. So it's a kind of an amalgamated team. I know Joanne's here. So so what we'll do, so Joanne, who's the star, do you want to stand up, Joanne? And yeah, well done. I think what a brilliant idea, and you know, so many opportunities coming from that. So what we'll do is we'll have a negotiation with the three of you about how we can help you as part of your prize, okay? But, you know, really very well done. And now we have the formal winner, okay? And if I can undo the string. The formal winner, as unanimously decided by the judging panel, is number one, 52 Faces from Lincolnshire Partnership NHS Foundation Trust. It's such a great idea. So if colleagues from Lincolnshire NHS Foundation Trust are listening in, absolute congratulations. Wonderful prize is coming to you. But also we want to talk with all the finalists because they were such great ideas. So, I mean, it's been amazing the last couple of days working with 59 different teams. And if I didn't know what amazing, creative, resourceful, imaginative people nurses and midwives were before, I certainly do now. So just to say thank you to Paul, thank you to Wendy, and thank you to you for coming and being part of the lecture, commemorating the wonderful Mona Gray, and here's to a future where, you know, people don't think about nursing and midwifery as subordinate roles and stereotype gender. Let's all work towards a future where everybody recognises what a brilliant, amazing career nursing is and midwifery is as well. So thank you all. And enjoy your evening.